Well, this exercise is finished, and we have noticed that by introducing this notation, the dimension, if we denote the dimension of the original, the containing vector space, the containing vector space is R3. If we denote by D the dimension of the space, D equal also n, because the dimension of the space is also the number of unknowns. Of unknowns, because we have x, y, z, three unknowns, because the vectors belong to R3 and they have three components. If we denote by the lower case D, for this exercise has been D equal to the dimension of the subspace, our subspace S, the subspace S, identified by this condition, as the subspace S has dimension 2. And then M is the number of conditions on, for this subspace, we have only one condition. These parameters are related by these relations, by these equalities. The difference between the dimension of the space and the dimension of the subspace is equal, is coincident with the number of equations, of conditions. All dimension of the space minus number of the equations, of the conditions, equal the dimension D. Let us suppose to repeat another exercise, to do another exercise. We fix the containing space R3, R4, Rn. Rn, n is the dimension of the space, obviously. And then we choose a subset by fixing n equations. Therefore, n equations having highest possible length. But anyway, it does not make any sense to write, for example, 2x minus y equals 0. If we add another condition of this kind, 4x minus 2y equals 0, the rank of the coefficient matrix is 1. Because the coefficient matrix is, the coefficient matrix is 2, negative 1, 0, 4, negative 2, 0. This matrix, 2, negative 1, 0, 4, negative 2, 0, has, I write it later, 2, negative 1, 0, 4, negative 2, 0, this matrix has rank 1, but these two conditions are equivalent, and then, since a rank 1 corresponds to a minor of order 1, excluding some equation, the equation excluded by the minor of the rank can be excluded from the beginning. We exclude this equation. It is unuseful to write the conditions so, such that 2x minus y equals 0 and 4x minus 2y equals 0. It does not make any sense to write the conditions in this way, because we can say it is without laws of generality. The equations, equations or conditions identifying effectively the subspace are those to which the highest possible length corresponds. Write two equations of rank 1 does not make any sense. It is possible, obviously, but the subset and the subspace is identified only by the equations involved in the minor for the rank. Okay? For this reason, it is always it will always be without laws of generality to consider here only a question of highest to which the highest possible rank corresponds. One equation corresponds to rank 1, two equations will correspond to rank 2, three equations to rank 3. I repeat, because I never write two equations of rank 1, three equations of rank 1 or 2. I never take, for identifying the subset, it is unuseful to take conditions to which corresponds a system having rank less than the number of equations. The rank of the conditions is always be, without laws of generality, is always equal to the number of the conditions themselves. Is it clear? If I take more equations than they rank, the minor itself will exclude exceeding equations. The exceeding equations are not relevant for the solution of the system. That is, are not relevant for finding these vectors. And then, if they are excluded by the minor in the system, they can be excluded already from the beginning. Okay, well, now let's imagine these possibilities. No condition, zero condition. Let us analyze all possibilities. Zero conditions can be written either so. I don't write any condition. That is, S in this way, in this case, is coincident with the entire R3, obviously. Okay? First possibility, but no condition is not very interesting. It is unuseful to write S with no conditions. S is coincident with R3, and then in this case we are still with R3. We have given no subspace. A subspace coincident with R3 is a trivial case. First possibility, zero condition. Zero conditions could be also realized in this other way. 0x plus 0y plus 0z equals 0. Okay? This is equivalent to no condition, because any vector of R3 satisfies this condition. First case, f coincident with R3 itself, with the space itself. Possible, but not very interesting. After zero conditions, we have one condition. And then, I write here, zero equations. The dimension of the subspace is D. D equal to the dimension of the space. Now we choose one condition, 2x minus y equals 0. In this case, this is of rank 1, one condition of rank 1. This is case has, the system has, in find2, dimension d minus 1, minus rank 1. Rank 1 minus 1 equation, if you want. The rank corresponds to the equations because we choose equations giving rise to a system whose coefficient matrix has rank, the highest possible rank. The highest possible rank is coincident with the number of equations. Zero equation. One equation corresponds to a subspace of dimension d minus 1. Two equations means, for example, here I add 2x minus y equals 0 and 3x minus z equals 0. Now I have given two conditions. This is another exercise. It would be another exercise. In this case, we write the system 2x minus y equals 0, 3x minus z equals 0. The system has rank 2, has a coefficient matrix of rank 2, if you write the coefficient matrix. Rank 2 by virtue of this minor. This minor of order 2. Negative 1, 0, 0, negative 1. Rank 2. If the rank is 2, the solutions will be in finite 2, 3 unknowns, 3 equal to the dimension of the space, minus rank, but the rank is equal to the number of equations. That is in finite 1. Here we have only one vector. If we solve this system, we extract the minor, minus y equal negative 2t, negative z equal negative 3t. That is, this is a style, it would be another exercise. That is, we write x equal, y equal, z equal. X out of the minor takes the arbitrary value t. And then y equal to t, I change the signs, z equal 3t. And then now, since x, y, z are the components of vectors, they are not coefficients, as in other cases, in other exercises we saw. X, y, z, since they are components of vectors, we rewrite them with the vector notation. X, y, z equal t in evidence 1, 2, 3. This is the vector spanning the subspace identified by these two conditions. Okay? It is a subspace because the subset consists of all possible linear combinations of this kind. K-vector, scales K equal 1 vector, with all possible linear combination. According the theory of the subspaces, property S1, if we want to verify the property S2 of the subspaces, we must repeat the same thing. Here we can write this subspace, the subset, consists of all vectors B, linear combinations of 1, 2, 3. Since the subset appears, arises as all linear combinations of given vectors, if only one vector in this case, this is a subspace. How many vectors can we extract from this subspace S in the set J? 4J to be a linearly independent set, we can extract only one vector. 1, 2, 3. Only one vector. This vector or other possible vectors of the space, of the subspace. Obviously, all other possible vectors must be of this kind. This vector or another vector of the linear taken from the linear combinations. And then this is a basis for the subspace, and the dimension is 1. The dimension 1 is also of the subspace, is also the exponent of Fouché-Capelli's theorem when we solve the system from the Cartesian representation to the parametric representation. Do you follow me? Well, then we could also, let us verify rapidly the property S2. The property S2. This is also a basis for the subspace. The basis, the dimension, and the basis are given by property S1. For this reason, I prefer to introduce the theory of the subspaces by considering those simultaneous properties S1 and S2. In this way, all is automatic. All comes alone. All comes automatically. Well, S1 and S2, then we will write these relations. I take U equal X1, X2, X3. Belonging to S. This means that U satisfies both conditions. Sorry, not x1, x2, x3, but x1, y1, z1. Now, U1, x1, y1, z1. This is a generic vector of S, but if it belongs to S, this means that this vector satisfies all conditions for S. 2x1 minus y1 equals 0. 3x1 minus z1 equals 0. Then we take W belonging to S. W equal x2 y2 z2 belonging to S. That is also the components of W satisfy both conditions. 2x2 minus y2 equals 0. 3x2 minus z2 equals 0. Now, this is taken. We take vectors in S. Subspace means that two vectors in S must have all possible linear combinations of them, again belonging to S itself. If UW belong to S, that is, if they satisfy these conditions, does any linear combination of UW still satisfy both conditions? We have to check. The generic linear combination will be alpha U plus beta W equal alpha X1 plus beta X2 comma alpha Y1 plus beta Y2 comma sorry, here we used RS RU plus SW RS RS RZ1 plus SZ2 RX RZ1 plus SZ2. Okay? This is the generic linear combination of two vectors belonging to S. Does this linear combination still verify the conditions of S? We check. We should verify two first components times first component. 2 RX1 plus SX2 minus the second component RY1 plus SY2 is equal 0. Let's check. Are in evidence 2x1 minus y1 plus S in evidence, S in evidence, 2x2 minus y2. But this is effectively 0 because 2x1 minus y1 is 0 because U belongs to S. And also 2x2 minus y2 is 0 because also W belongs to S. And then the first condition is satisfied by the linear combination. Let's check the second condition. The second condition is 3 times the first component. 3 times R x1 plus x plus s x2. 3 times first component of the linear combination. Minus third component. Minus third component is this one. RZ1 plus SZ2. Is this equal 0? That is, does the linear combination verify also the second condition? Let's expand and verify. R in evidence times R in evidence times 3x1 plus minus z, minus z1. Our evidence R is here, here. 3x1 minus z1. Close the bracket. Plus s in evidence times 3x2 minus z2. But this is zero because 3x1 minus z1 is zero because u belongs to 2s. 3x2 minus z2 is zero because also w belongs to 2s. And then the subset, by solving the system, the subset is equal to consists of all possible linear combinations of given vectors, fixed vectors. Fixed vectors, the vectors are fixed by the solution of the system. But now we have verified that also the property S2 is verified. The second property, the second equivalent property for the subspaces is verified. That's all we have for this situation. And now we can say, we can summarize, a subspace can arise, can be identified by what, in which way? Either through with some homogeneous, linear homogeneous equations, either with homogeneous Cartesian equation, or as linear combinations of fixed vectors. From the Cartesian representation, we obtain the vector representation as linear combination by solving the system. And we can verify that the Cartesian equations also verify the property S2, the second property. Now we should do the opposite, that is, from the parametric equation, the parametric representation from S1, S1 tells that the subspace consists of all possible linear combinations of some vector. We have to pass to obtain the Cartesian representation. The parametric representation, we can say, is given by S1. The parametric representation corresponds to S1. The Cartesian representation allows us to immediately verify the property S2. We could say, to fix the ideas, the Cartesian representation corresponds a little more to the second property. Now I show you how to pass from the parametric representation to the Cartesian representation. But before we do the vice versa, I want to go back to the consideration about the numbers. Now, all should be clear. Zero equations would identify the entire vector space. The subspace is trivial, is coincident with the vector space. If we have one equation, from one equation we get a two-dimensional space vector, a two-dimensional vector subspace, as in the previous exercise. Because with one equation we obtain infinite to 2, 3 minus 1. 3 minus 1 equation equal infinite to 2 solutions. 2 vectors, bidimensional subspace. With 2 equations we have infinite 2, dimension of the space minus number of equations. That is infinite to 1 solutions. Find one solution, one is the dimension of the subspace. And so, with two equations, we have a vector subspace of dimension d minus 2. 3 minus 2 equals dimension 1. And so on. Okay. If we give, let us suppose, as how we would solve another exercise, if we would consider such that 2x minus y equals 0, comma, 3x minus z equals 0, comma, as before. Let us imagine to add another condition. X plus y minus x plus 2y minus 3z equals 0. In this case, what would it happen? Very simple. Always without laws of generality, with rank 3, three equations of rank 3. It does not make sense that we write here another equation and then the rank is 2 by virtue of a minor of order 2. A minor of order 2 would exclude the third equation. And then the third equation is unuseful, is irrelevant, would not play any role. An effective m equations are effective m equations if their rank is equal to the number of equations, not strictly less than. In this case, I write here x plus 2y minus 3z equals 0. I cancel the minor. Here I leave to you to verify that the rank is effectively 3. But if the rank is 3, the rank 3 is equal to the unknown, to the number of unknowns, to the number 3 of the unknowns. This system would have unique solution, the trivial solution. And then the subspace in this case would be with three equations, I cancel here, three equations, in English one writes in plural, one has to write EQS. With three equations, the dimension is d minus 3, but d minus 3, in this case, 3 minus 3, means that the subspace consists of the vector only. Unique solution, only the trivial solution, signalize, tells us that the subspace consists of the vector only. Is it clear? Is this hierarchy? The hierarchy of subspace is clear? Zero equations corresponds to a subspace coincident with the entire space. And then every equation reduces the dimension of the subspace. Can we add a fourth equation? A fourth equation? No. Because if we write x, y, z, this matrix A, for having four rows and three columns, would have always rank 3, the minimum number, but rank 3 equal to the number of unknowns. If I would continue to add equations, always the vector, I would identify always the vector. Okay? The possible number, the highest possible number of equations for a subspace is the same number of the dimension of the space. For R3, we can have subspaces from 0 equations to 3 equations. But the end points, the extrema, the zero equations and n equation are n, and n equations give rise to trivial subspaces. The proper subspaces are identified by a number of equations between one and, in this case, one, two. These are the proper subspaces. Dimension D has R3 and dimension 0 has the null vector only R3. The number of equations would go from, the number of equations goes from 1, 2, 3 dots D minus 1. Coincident with n minus 1 of Rn. If we have R4, the proper subspaces are identified by, for inside R4, by one equation or two equations or three equations only. 4 minus 1 is 3. Then one equation gives dimension D minus 1, two equations D minus 2, D minus 3 here, D minus 1 only, D and D are cancelled out, 1. This is dimension 1. One equation, if we have, it should be clear, if we have R5, one equation corresponds to D minus 1, dimension 4 of the subspace. Two equations, dimension 3. Three equations, dimension 2. Four equations, dimension 1. Five equations, the null vector only. These are the proper subspaces. If this is clear, this summarizes all what we have done until now. This summarizes the concepts of linear dependent and independent sets, rank of the matrices, Ruscha-Capelli's theorem, and dimension of the subspaces. And then rank of a set of vectors, rank of the sets, subspaces, dimension of the subspaces, all is rotates, all is described essentially by Ruscha-Capelli's theorem. I repeat, the parameter, the relation between the parameters, if we have D coincident with N equal dimension of the space lowercase d equal dimension of the subspace M equal number of equations. We have already discussed all. I write the relation discussed here. D minus D equal N, or D minus m d minus m equal d. These are the relations. But it is not surprising because we have when we write m equations of rank m, of rank m, the rank of the system without laws of generality can be always considered as equal to the number of the equation. These are equal zero homogeneous equations, and then how many are the solutions? Infinite to number of unknowns, but the number of unknowns is the dimension of the space. D minus the rank, but the rank is m, equal infinity to d. D minus m equal the dimension of the infinite in the Euclidean theorem. That's all. I break the record and I show you how to pass from the